and one of the first things he does, having rented it, is to bar his own landlord. Now, you might argue two things from that. He might object to Rafe as a neighbour, as he declares he does, or it might be that he didn't want the county to suppose he was at all friendly with him. The fact that Rafe never came over here means nothing. Both he and Nunn are frequently in town. And the whole thing was a blind, and he and Rafe were in the gang together? I should say unquestionably yes. I wonder what the chap did in the war. Archie Fraser could probably find that out for me. I'll send him a line today. There must have been some kind of split between Nunn and Rafe, though, for Rafe to have started blackmailing Nunn's wife. I should imagine that if, as seems pretty certain, Cleghorn has been dead for years, Rafe must have had those letters for a considerable time. He wouldn't use them, of course, so long as his relations with Nunn were good, but when they quarrelled, possibly about Hillary, then Rafe played his winning card. You think that a man who hasn't scrupled to blackmail for years would refuse to let Hillary marry his partner? I asked. I dare say that wasn't Nunn's doing at all. It seemed much more likely to have been his wife's. Lady Nunn is no fool, and her husband would have to throw dust in her eyes to prevent her getting suspicious. She may have come to him and said that at all costs he's to prevent a marriage between Hillary and Rafe. He had a lot at stake, remember? I think the trouble between them was genuine, not just part of a plan. Rafe wouldn't quarrel with a man as rich as Nunn if he could avoid it. And once that position arose, Nunn really had no option. Rafe's strength was that he had nothing to lose. His reputation was in shreds, and he possibly decided to marry Hillary, replace Nunn at the Abbey, and settle down to respectability.